We were telling about what is intention, and also we have went on to see there are two factors. I didn't bring the tablet, therefore little bit difficult to write. I have additional tablet to write. Okay, that I don't have now, but anyway, I'll try for using mouse there, but that may not be better. So there are two determinants of attention. One is external factors and the other one is internal factors. And external factor are outside us. Otherwise, it is called as objective determinants, objective factors. Okay, internal factors are within us. And therefore, the other name for that, subjective factors of determinants. Okay, so you should also know what are the other names. So external factors are otherwise called as objective factors. Internal factors are otherwise called as subjective factors. Subjective means it is within us. It is within us. If it is outside us, then it is called objective factors. Okay. So there are two types of question: objective questions and subjective questions. What are objective questions? So you know that what are objective questions? I'm trying to write, but my handwriting may not be good. What are objective questions? You have you heard that word, objective question?
Yes, sir.
Yes, tell me what are
Yes,
objective
sir.
questions?
One
Yes,
more
sir.
question.
One more questions are called objective questions. Give some examples for one more question.
Multiple choice, Phillips.
Yes. Multiple choice, Phillips, true or false. So all
Match
those things
the
are, yes.
format. Match the format. Please, in an assertion.
Okay. Multiple choice, fill in the blanks, true or false, odd man out. So all these are one mark question, which we call it as objective questions. Why we call it as objective questions? Any reason for that? There'll be some reason, no? We call that name. So when these questions, if you are attending this question, for teacher, there are no choice. If there is a correct answer, we have to put one. If the question is wrong, we have to put zero. So it will not depend upon us. The scoring does not depend upon the scorer. Therefore, it is called as objective question. What is the opposite of another type of question? What is the
Subjective
opposite
question.
of
Subjective.
that? Subjective question. Examples?
Definition. Definitions. Paragraph.
Yes, essay
Experience.
question. Essay question, short answer question. Questions of 2 marks, of 3 marks, 5 marks, and 10 marks. All we call this put under the category subjective question. Why? Because the scoring, sometimes it depends upon the scorer. Maybe many times, depends upon the scorer. Because if you suppose if you are writing an essay question of 10 marks, if you give to 10 different scorers, 10 different teachers, will they put same marks? 10 teachers for that
No,
10 mark
sir.
question? No, they won't put.
Okay.
They'll be different. One teacher may put 9, one teacher may put 10, one teacher may put 8. It depends because some teacher may go by the handwriting, some teacher may go by the colors, which is this, writing in red, blue, and then hibiscus, something. So if you see, since I am teacher for more than 25 years, the answers written by women students or girl students is different from the answers written by a female male student. Boys and girls, we can easily distinguish a paper written by a boy. Generally, I'm speaking. Written by a boy or written by a girl, because the girls know they used to decorate. Generally, they used to decorate the answers, or they used to put the lines, or they use different colors. And our boys, it is simple that if they write the answer, that is good. With that, they live. Okay, so. Actually, to reduce the subjectiveness, we follow one thing. what is that in 10th standard and 12th standard, we have to reduce the subjectiveness, otherwise many cases will come to the courts. And that to reduce the subject, what we provide what we call the scoring key to the teachers at the camps, evaluation camps. So if for essay question, if this is there, you give 1 mark. If this is there, you give 2 mark. If this is there, you give 3 marks. That 10 mark, no, it is broken down. It is broken down into 2 mark, half a mark, 2 mark. For a figure, you give 2 marks. If you break like this, the 10 mark question, then the objectivity increases, subjectivity decreases. Like that, only 10th and 12th are have been corrected. And since we will get a lesser subjectiveness. Okay. Therefore, the attention which is within us, we call subjective determinants of attention. That the attention which is determined by outside factors, we call objective determinants of attention. Okay. So in that we have seen 2 things. The one which is size, the font size, the size, generally the size. The size, if it is bigger or if it is too smaller, we will give our attention. See, whatever we see, we have to, as a teacher at last, we have to think how this can be utilized in our classes. Because as from the beginning class, I am saying, why do we learn sensation? Why do we learn perception? Why do we learn attention? So why we learn all these things? Since we are teacher, we have to incorporate in our teachings. We learn this, at last we are going to incorporate in our teaching. We have to keep our students in attention. So if I want to keep my student in attention mode, not in sleeping mode, then I have to know what is attention, which one determines attention. If I know these things, then I could try in my class. So that is why you people are reading, and I also read attention and determine. Okay, so the first one is the size. Sometimes that's why we have to write. I have said how we write in class, how we write in notebooks, there is a difference. And the second one, what is that we have seen?
Intensity.
So that's what that song I have put. Okay. But intensity means highness in sound, but I didn't use it, but little bit melodious I have chosen, because suddenly I cannot go for a high pitch of sound. If I go high pitch, if some of you are using headset, no, then your ear will be affected. That's what I went on to melodious. Even in classes, no, sometimes if a teacher keeps on teaching, if some student are not attentive, what we will say? If we keep teaching, if some students are not attending in the class, what a teacher will say? So general question, you can just try. Even if it is wrong, no, nothing in that, no issue. Hey, look here. We will say, hey, where are you looking? Look here. That time, we will raise our voice. Teacher will raise the voice. So normally we will be teaching, teachers will be teaching. If some are not attentive, sometimes we call that name. Hey Hari, what you are doing? So look at the class, where you are looking. So that tone will be little bit higher than the normal classroom audio level. So I will call by name, or I will call that, and I will say, look at the class. So that will be a little bit higher intensity. So if higher intensity is provided, no, then they will wake up from their dreams and then look at the classes. Okay. So that way, the second one is intensity. Okay. The first one is size. The second one is intensity. Intensity means higher in pitch. Okay. And don't go by my own example. I have used a little, not higher intensity music, little bit. Just for fun, I took that, and I have to provide different things now. If I If I put the same thing, it will be not good. Therefore, just for fun, I put some a song which was good. And the third one. So what you see, what you have seen, the word?
Motion.
Motion. What we mean by motion?
Movement.
Movement. You see movement, but how it has come? How the letters have come before you?
One by one.
One by one, by moving. See, now what we are seeing? We are seeing change. The third component in objective determinant of attention is change. So, just if I, so normally, how we write in, if I am teaching motion in class, in physics class, a physics teacher teaching about motion in a class, they will write like this only. Just by left to right, not by top to bottom, one by one. So if I change the mode, then it can cause the attention. It will cause. See, the teacher is writing differently. This is what one of my students did in her teaching. I use in my class. This is not of mine. So as you people in seventh semester, you have to teach in the class. We keep on trying you from first semester to seventh semester. We keep trying you in teaching what that we call it as micro teaching. So we train you, and then in fifth semester you'll get your training in teaching, and seventh semester you'll be doing actually teaching. So in those one teaching, as we used to observe, one of my students, she used the writing of motion in this way. One below the other, as like to show a movement. So a little change in the methodology, just writing, you see, we captured the attention of the students. Okay. Likewise, a teacher, they have to change the methodology, daily lecturing. If you daily lecture in class, what will happen? Slowly they start sleeping in class. So one day you lecture, one day you go for demonstration, one day you go for questioning, one day you take them out and teach somewhere under a tree. Okay. So if at all, if possible, we can use different methods. Change. That's what we say, change only is constant. What does this mean? Change only is constant. What we mean by that? Change only is constant.
Nothing is permanent.
Yes, nothing is permanent. It has to undergo change. So change is constant. So we have to keep on changing in the class. Today, lecture method. Tomorrow, demonstration. Day after tomorrow, learning by doing. If you allow different method, then the class will be a little bit attractive. So that is the third one. What is this? What is the fourth one?
A whiteboard.
Yes, a whiteboard. Aman?
One board is different.
One board is different. And hence, what is the factor's name? What is the determinant?
Contrast.
Contrast. Good. Contrast. What is it? One more.
Color, sir.
Color. Yes. The contrast is the correct answer. Maybe the color is due to the contrast. Color is the base for the difference. Okay. You are saying the base. The name is contrast. Okay. So just, if you see a whiteboard among blackboards, the whiteboard stands alone. You can easily distinguish. So this we call contrast. If like a black dot in a white shirt. So if we wear a white shirt, in which a black dot is there, then that is easily visible. While a white dot in black shirt may not be that much visible, but a black dot in a white shirt is very much visible. So that causes our attention, that creates the attention. Others can easily say, hey, in your shirt, there is a black dot. Easily they can say. So because it causes the attention, immediately catches. Okay. So how to implement in class? What are the ways? So the factor is contrast. You suggest some ways how this factor contrast be implemented in class.
Sir, that is blackboard, white chalk piece.
Yes, correct. Blackboard, white chalk piece. Yes, that is a contrast. Sometimes now we have green board also. Or whiteboard also, we use different colors, as like Sunil sir is using. That is basically contrast. So if you use different colors, then it causes attention in the minds of the students. Therefore, they see the blackboard. Okay, so that's what contrast. Even teaching, no, when teaching concepts, no. Suppose if you are telling. The examples of metals. Normally, one negative example also you can give. Suppose if you teach metals, maybe like gold, silver, chromium, nickel, all those things are example. But carbon is. Gold, silver, nickel, chromium are the examples of metal. But carbon?
Non-metal.
So it's a contrast. So if you are saying many positive examples, students will understand. But also little time you say a negative example. If you say that, then the conceptual understanding will be better. It's not that always we should say the positive part only. You contrast it. Whenever we teach contrast, not only in boards. Even in concepts, if you put a little bit different concept, see what I am teaching is metal only, I am also saying a case of non-metal. So that they compare and contrast, they can easily understand the differences and the concepts. It's a better conceptual understanding. So in that way, a teacher can use it in a class. What is it? What is that you are seeing?
Vitamin A is missing, sir.
Oh, good. Therefore, it means that. A is missing. If A is not there, then what do you call that? If vitamin A is not there, then what do you call? It is vitamin A deficiency. Just putting it in different way, that's all. It does not mean like that. But we can write in a different way. If we write like this, it means that it is a vitamin A deficiency. Okay. If I write like that, what does this mean? A letter is missing.
A letter is missing.
F is missing.
F is missing.
Missing, yes. Letter is missing. Any meaning? Just try to get some meaning out of it.
Spelling mistake.
Wonderful man. It's not spelling.
Superscript.
Yes, sir. There is a break between letters. The break is between F and E. There is a break, and it is called as coffee break. If we write like this, it means that now the time, now it's a time for coffee break. But don't go now. Listen to the class. See, putting it differently. Don't see it as a mistake. If I write vitamin like this, it means that vitamin A deficiency. If I write coffee like that, it means that now the time is for coffee break. And what is the name of the factor?
Novelty, sir.
Very good, novelty. What do you mean by novelty?
A new interesting thing.
The other name for novelty is? The other name for novelty is creativity. What is creativity? What is creativeness?
Innovative.
You are saying another term. Define innovation. Putting new ideas. Creating new ideas. That is what called novelty. And this is the what I have shown to you. Of course, this is not mine. I have taken from some other. Just I am incorporating in the class. So, telling vitamin A deficiency in a novel way, in a new way, it's a novelty in class. So, like this, we can adopt in class. If you are creative enough, then you can always capture your students' attention indefinitely. A teacher has to be creative. So not all the time monotonously using the same thing, it will just go in a different way so that we can catch students' attention. Okay, there is a little story about a blind boy. So there was a blind boy in the pedestrian crossing. So he was sitting and he was begging for money, food or something, but nothing was given to him. But one man, when he saw that, and he placed a board in front of the blind boy and went. And after that, you see many people, if they are crossing that blind boy, they have put many money. So what was written in that board? What he has written? Have you heard this story? So that man has written, "Today is a beautiful day. I am unable to see it." That is the word he has written in that board. So it's not that, so give me money means we will get irritation. Normally the beggars, if they beg, just put money, give money. If they tell like that, then we will be irritated. Normally, sometimes we avoid it and we will go our way. See, that beggar, that blind boy, he didn't beg, but he has put his way in a differently. That man helped. Today is a beautiful day, but I am unable to see the world. So this catches attention. The others will understand the prettiness of the blind boy, and therefore they have put the arms. They have put the money. So that's what I am saying. Sometimes, if you are creative, the creative teachers are always honored. You remember this time, one teacher in North India, he got a Global Teacher Award. You know the name? Just some months ago, 3 or 4 months. One North Indian, he got the Global Teacher Award. You know about him? Just I am unable to recollect his name. Anyone?
Ranjit Singh.
I think it's correct. Ranjit Singh. Yes. What does he did? What did he do?
He is in primary school, sir.
Okay, he is in primary school. What for he got that award? What was his major contribution? What was his major novelty?
Sir, life changes of young girls in her school.
Life changes?
Of young girls in her school, in his school, sir. He changes her life.
Very good, ma'am. You won't get fail in examination, ma'am. Good answer. His contribution is, you know, nowadays in books also, now even in Tamil Nadu, I don't know about other states, but in central government books, no, KV books, and in also Tamil Nadu books, we have that QR code. Even in school books, if you scan that QR code, no, if it is a poem, you can get an audio of that poem. Somebody is singing that was recorded in and it's stored in somewhere in websites. You can get some videos. You can get questions. So this QR code is introduced by the Ranjit Singh. Very first time Ranjit Singh incorporated QR code in the books. So that was taken by the Indian government and across the world now they are using. It's a wonderful invention, you know. See, whenever I was kid, no, just I have books only in white and black. That's all. No other thing in the book. Only it will be white and black. But nowadays, after 90s or after 2000, we got colorful books, starting from kindergarten. Nowadays, books comes with QR code. Just on that lesson, if some experiment is there, some botany photosynthesis, if you scan it, then you can directly visualize an experiment on photosynthesis. So how could it be? So the student learns better. Okay. So we are putting the students in a better position, the information. So the how to sing, how to recite the poem, all those things are there. And this was the invention by the Ranjit Singh. Hence the award. See, it's fitting, no? The word is very much fitting. So now it's globally used. So this is what creativity. Right? Novelty, and the other name creativity, the other name innovation. Here is a question. So you are there at 2 meters from the basket. You have to throw the ball from 2 meters. There are three choices. From the distance of 2 meters, if you are throwing a ball and if it falls on the basket, you will get 2 marks. If you are standing at 4 meters and throwing the ball, you will get 5 marks. If you are standing at a distance of 6 meters and then throwing the ball, you'll get 10 marks. So there are three positions, and as the distance increases, the mark increases. Okay. So Pragadeshwaran, now, if you are given choice, where will you stand and throw the ball? Pragadesh?
Yes, sir.
If you are given chance, where will you stand and throw the ball to the basket? Just tell a path why you are taking this much time. 2 meters, 4 meters or 6 meters?
2 meters, sir.
Okay, Srinika, where will you stand?
Yes, sir. 2 meters.
Okay, Varun Sai, where will you stand?
4 meters, sir.
Rajasaranya.
4 meters.
Punila.
4 meters, sir.
Amal.
Sir, 10 meters.
2 meters, sir.
10 meters. Aminash.
2 meters, sir.
Okay. So the majority of the answer is 2 meters. I can ask all, but anyway, due to time, it's just a sample. Majority of you are telling 2 meters. Why?
Sir, probability is more, sir.
Yes. You are safe. You will get at least 2 marks. If you are standing and throwing, no? Anyway, this topic is little bit, discussion is little bit away from the attention. But why I am showing this? What is the factor now? What is the factor? The factor is movement. Movement. But anyway, I am not going for that discussion why you are selecting 2, 4 and all. I will restrict. Just if I tell without this, you imagine without this diagram, if I tell no, there will be a little bit misunderstanding. Easily we cannot get it. But if I use these diagrams, there is a man standing, the basket is there, ball is there, see, their demarcations are there, then you will be easily understanding. And also there is a movement of the ball. So it makes the understanding very easily. Okay. Therefore, as a teacher, we have to use a dynamic working model, not a static working model. What is a static working model? What is a dynamic working model? Easy question, no?
So static means stable, sir.
Dynamic
is moving, sir.
Very good, very good. See, this is a very simple toy. A toy of how a lift works. It's very easily built with Pascal's. I can use for Pascal's law also. You can also show how a weight being lifted. You can use for two things. So this is the example of how a Pascal's law work. So there are two syringes with water. If you press the syringe which is at the bottom, the water gets inside and it pushes the other syringe towards up and which is connected to the lift. Hence the weight is being lifted. So this is a working model. Okay. The Pascal's law attached to a lift. Okay, the working of Pascal. So if a teacher shows, if a physics teacher, if he or she teaches only Pascal's law without this, no, you think of that class. And you think of another class where a teacher uses this model and teaches. Where will be the achievement more? In which class the achievement will be more?
With the experiment.
In that class in which this activity is being used. Okay. Therefore, we have to use the one which moves, not a static. Even though just a teacher should not stand in a particular place throughout the time in the class. A teacher should move. He or she should not stand in a particular place for all the 45 minutes in a class. Why? Is anybody there?
Yes, sir.
Yes, why? It's a simple question, no? We can discuss. If a teacher stands in a place for...
pay attention, sir.
If I am standing, just you think real class, offline class, not a virtual class. So if I am standing in a particular place for all the 45 minutes, and normally students will see the teacher only, teacher and the blackboard, both. If I am standing in a particular place and if you are seeing me on that place only for the full period, may it be 1 hour, easily you will be getting tired. Your eyes will be tired because your eyeballs, no, it won't be moving. Since I am standing in a place and your eyeballs will be in that place only, it won't move to the left or right. It will be static. That is what you told in the beginning last semester. No, you told you cannot see lengthier period of time this online class. So you have to little bit turn your head, turn your eyeballs so that it will be refreshed. So that if you are standing in a class for a lengthy period of time, then you will get be easily tired. That is why we have to move. So that is one micro skill in teaching. One of the micro skill in teaching, which we will be telling in micro teaching in fifth semester. Okay. So that's what movement is necessary. It's better than static. Is audio is coming?
Yes, sir.
No, sir.
No, sir.
No, sir.
The clapping sound. Are you hearing the clapping sound?
No, sir.
Okay. Anyway, audio is not required, but I have to check why audio is not. Okay. How many people are you in NCC? Total?
So five people, sir.
How many boys and girls?
So three boys, two girls, sir.
Two girls. How to get this skill that man, that sir is walking in the middle and see how casually he goes and comes in between the rifles. How did we get this skill? How can we get this skill?
Practice, sir.
That's all. Only practice. Only we have to repeatedly do according to the time. It's possible. This is possible, but seemingly it is difficult. But it can be achieved. Since before us one person is doing, it's achievable. But you have to maintain the times. Initially, we may not be getting. If we may fall on him also, because if it falls, you see there is a knife also at the one end. If it falls, then we will be getting some physical assault, some physical wounds on our body. So this can be practiced. So repetition is a determinant of attention. If we are unattentive, no, but we can increase our attentiveness by giving repetition. If it is being repeated, then attention may increase. So that is the last but one factors. The last factor is this. What is this? What is this? Or what is this?
Reflection.
Yes, a mahal in the riverside. A mahal in the riverside. This is the correct figure. The previous one is I deliberately inverted and kept. Something unable to understand easily. But if I put like this, this one is the correct one. The Mahal, you can see the dome at the top and the riverside, and also you can see the shore. So it's a correct figure. If we invert like this, then it's not easily understood. Some misunderstanding may arise. Therefore, it is the part of the teacher to organize the things before going to the class, systematic form. So whatever we are going to teach now, we have to arrange it in a particular way, and that is what we call it as advanced organizer model. We have one theory, I think we may also learn in higher classes. So advanced organizer model, maybe it may be coming in here also, I do not know. So in advanced organizer model by Asrable, what he says is, we have to previously organize the class. Before teaching, you organize it, what you are going to teach in first place. Second place, what you are going to tell. Third, what you are going to tell. What are the materials you have for your class? So if you are going in an organized way, and if you are putting the stimulus in a systematic form, in class they can easily understand. As like this image. If I put it correctly, then it is easy to understand. If I put it wrongly, then it is difficult to understand. Because I have not, here I did it deliberately, the first figure. But if a teacher is not organized, if he or she is not presenting the stimulus in a systematic way, then the class may not be better. Okay, great. So with this, I close this period, and just we will summarize of today's class. So we have completed the leftover of the six external determinants. We started with the first one, size, the second one, intensity, the third one,
change.
Fourth,
contrast.
Fifth,
novelty.
Sixth,
movement.
Seventh,
repetition.
And eighth, systematic.
Systematic.
All these we have seen, and also with classroom examples we have seen how a teacher could. That's what. See, for every whatever the concepts we learn, the last point is that classroom implication. How, as a teacher, we can use this in our classrooms. So with all these things we have seen, that is why it has taken this much time. Just by reading all those eight things, it may not take more than 20 seconds. But we have given examples then and there, and also then and there we have said in classroom how this can be implemented. Okay, so that's not very important for us, classroom implication. So we should learn the concepts, attention, sensation, perception, and after learning, as a teacher, we have to keep in mind that we have to implement these in our own classrooms. Then that will be good. Any questions?